Students, in our previous videos we have started a new chapter of class 10. The name of the chapter is a pair of linear equations in two variables. In this chapter we have learnt a lot of things in earlier videos. The first one, how to write the standard form of pair of linear equations, what are the methods for its solution, what is the meaning of consistent pair and inconsistent pair of linear equations, what are the algebraic methods by which we can solve and get a solution for the linear pair of equations. So moreover, we have also discussed the different algebraic methods, such that substitution method, elimination method and cross multiplication method. So in this context it is time to solve some questions from the NCERT book, because without solving you cannot able to estimate yourself, you are not able to judge yourself what you have learned. So get ready and solve some questions. So exercise 3.1, chapter 3, the name of the chapter is pair of linear equations in two variables. Let us read the question number 1. Question number 1 says, Aftab tells his daughter. What Aftab told his daughter? 7 years ago I was 7 times as old as you were then. Also 3 years from now I shall be 3 times as old as you will be. So represent this situation. We have given 2 situations in this question. Represent this situation algebraically and graphically. So let us consider Aftab's present age as x years and his daughter present age as y years. So we should read the question once again. What Aftab told his daughter. Aftab tells his daughter, 7 years ago I was 7 times as old as you were then. So if Aftab's present age is x years, so 7 years ago his age was x minus 7, and the age of her daughter, so the age of his daughter 7 years ago was y minus 7. So according to question, what Aftab told his daughter, 7 years ago I was 7 times as old as you were. So we should multiply his daughter's age with 7. After 7 years ago the age of Aftab was 7 times whatever the age of his daughter was 7 years ago. So we can represent x minus 7 equal to 7y minus 49 equal to x minus 7y minus 7 plus 49 equal to 0. X minus 7y and plus 42. This is the first equation which we got from the first situation. So this is the algebraic expression of the first situation. Now read the question once again. After also what Aftab told his daughter, also 3 years from now. So if Aftab's age is 6 years right now, so after 3 years his age will be x plus 3 and his daughter's age will be y plus 3. So what Aftab told, 3 years from now I shall be 3 times as old as you will be. So we should multiply his daughter's age, whatever it will be after 3 years, with 3. So x plus 3 equal to 3y plus 9. So 3y comes to this side, so x minus 3y and this 9 also. So plus 3 minus 9 equal to 0, x minus 3y minus 6 equal to 0. So this is the second equation which we got after solving second situation. So this is the algebraic situation. We have solved this equation as algebraically. Now we are going to represent these two situations graphically. Now we are going to represent the situation graphically. For that we should write first the first equation, x minus 7y plus 42 equal to 0. Now what we can do here, we should eliminate x or y from the equation. So how can we do that? So we should write x equal to 7y minus 42. So
here we eliminate x. Now we plot a table. We have learnt about it in the previous class. So we write here x and y. Now if we take the value of y as 6, then we get x as 0. 7 into 6, 42, 42 minus 42, 0. So we get the value of x as 0. Similarly, if we take the value of y as 5, so 7 into 5, 35, and 35 minus 42, minus 7. So we have got two solutions. Similarly, for second equation, x minus 3y minus 6 equal to 0. What we can write here? If we want to eliminate x, x equal to 3y plus 6. So again, we plot a table. If we put y, if we put minus 2 at the place of y, so what we can get? 3 into minus 2, minus 6. Minus 6 plus 6, 0. And if we get, if we write here 3 minus 3 at the place of y, if we put minus 3, so 3 into minus 3, minus 9, minus 9 plus 6, minus 3. So we have got again two values for equation number 2, and that was the equation number 1. Now we are going to plot these points on the graph paper. Now we are going to plot the graph for the first equation. For this, we should do x-axis, and we know that the vertical axis is known as y-axis and the horizontal axis is known as x-axis. So we should write here x, this will be x dash, y and y dash. This is the origin, we know that, where both the axes meet. So for we are going to plot the points of the first equation in this graph paper. So the value of x is y, the value of x is 0 here, and the value of y is 6. So before that, we are going to write the value of abscissa here. Now we are going to plot this point. The first point is 0 and 6. So 0 is the value of 0 is x on this origin, and the value of 6, the value of y is 6. So this will be the point 0 and 6. Similarly, the next point we have to locate on the graph paper is minus 7 and 5. So the value of x here is, it is minus 7, and the value of y is 5 here. So both the line parallels to both the axes meets at here. So this will be the point minus 7 and 5. So now we connect these two points with a ruler. So this line represents the first equation. That was x minus 7y plus 42. We should write here x minus 7y plus 42. Similarly, on the next graph, we can represent another equation. Similarly, we do the same. In this case also, this one is x axis, this one is y axis, this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, 1, this is the y axis, 1, 2, 3, and below the x axis there will be minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, and minus 4. Now we are going to locate this point. The first point is 0 and minus 2. So 0 is at the origin, and minus 2, the value of ordinates, that is here. So this will be the point 0 and minus 2. Similarly, in the next point, we have to locate minus 3 and minus 3. The value of x is minus 3 and the value of y is also minus 3. So this, the value of x is minus 3 here and the value of y is minus 3 here. So both line will meet at here. So this will be minus 3 and minus 3. Now we can join these two points. So this is the graphical representation of both the equation of the question. In each and every questions, in each and every questions, from we have three questions in exercise 3.1. We have solved the first question. Similarly, you can also solve the other two questions.